Hello everyone, I am Professor Shani Sahai from EC Department, SIRT, Bhopal. Today in this lecture, I will introduce the networks. First, the performance parameters of a series of identical network. It is mainly consist of characteristic impedance and the propagation constant. Where the efficient propagation, the network is to be terminated by characteristic impedance and the propagation constant should be an imaginary part. This is the network components of Z1 and Z2. This is your T type of network and this is your pi type network. Two series arm, one shunt arm. In this one series and two shunt arm. Symmetrical T sections from L section. We can combine two L section to form one T section, or one T section can be split into two half L sections. So these Z1 is equal to Z2 and that is equals to Z1 by 2. Now in this case, we have combined two L section in the form of pi sections. So these series impedance will become Z1 and the shunt arm is twice Z2 and twice Z2. Both T and pi are considered as built of unsymmetrical L half section which are connected together in form of T and pi. A series connection of several T and pi networks leads to so-called ladder networks and which are indistinguishable one from the other except for the end of terminating L half sections. This is the ladder network made from T section. Here we have connected, like it is clear in the picture that T sections are connected in series to form one ladder section. Series shunt forms the ladder section. Now here in this section we have formed the ladder network built from the pi network. So here also we have connected pi in cascaded mode and we form a ladder section, series shunt. Now for a symmetrical network, this is image impedance. For a symmetrical network, we are considered two type of impedances. One it is image and other is your iterative. The image impedance and the Z1i and Z2i are equal to each other and the image impedance is then called the characteristic impedance. If we have both the image terminating impedances and input impedances are equal, then the image impedance will be converted in the form of characteristic impedance. In the symmetrical T network, where it is terminated in Z0, its input impedance will also be in Z0. Now the term iterative impedance, we have considered the iterative impedance where the input terminal, the measured value is equal to the terminating load value. For symmetrical T section, the characteristic impedance we have derived by, we have connected the Z1, Z2, Z2 and the terminated load is Z0 and the input impedance is also equals to Z0. We have derived with the help of the network. So in this case, the characteristic impedance will come as to be as Z1 square by 4 plus Z1 into Z2. Now this is the characteristic impedance for a symmetrical T section. This is the characteristic impedance of the pi section. Here we have also derived the formula for the characteristic impedance of the pi network. It is clearly given as. Now we have also derived with the help of the product of ZOC and ZSC, open circuit impedance. If we made this terminal as open, so this and this will be in series. If this is short circuited, then this and this will be in parallel and come in series with Z1 into Z2. Propagation constant. The magnitude ratio does not express the complete network performance. The phase angle should also be represented there. So e to the power of gamma is I1 upon I2 or V1 upon V2, where gamma is a complex variable and it is given by alpha plus j beta. So we have taken gamma as a complex variable and which have two values. A is the magnitude or attenuation constant and beta is the phase. Here we have described it. Phase constant. If a number of sections all have a common Z naught, then the ratio of current will be given by this relation. Z naught and gamma of symmetrical network. Now we will introduce the characteristic impedance and the gamma. And we have also derived the arms in terms of the propagation constant. And we have derived the formula for the propagation constant of the symmetrical network. And we have taken gamma is equals to natural log. The input impedance of any T network terminated in any impedance ZR, which may be written in terms of hyperbolic functions. We have derived Zin, ZSC, and then the tan hyperbolic gamma is equals to under root of ZSC upon ZOC, and the characteristic impedance is the geometrical product or mean of open circuit impedance and the short circuit impedance. Now we have also considered the filter fundamentals for the pass and stop band also. Here we have converted the sine gamma propagation in the terms of Z1 and 4Z2. And this condition implies a stop band for attenuation band. This is the phase angle in the pass band and this is the stop band. These are the condition of the impedances stop band, pass band. This is the cutoff frequency, where the frequency at which the network changes from pass band to stop band. So this is the condition for the pass band and stop band. And this is all. Thank you.